Hey everyone, welcome back to the bandwagon. I'm Luis, here with Matt and of course Julie for as long as she blesses us with her presence. We're going to be talking suspension today. This is a kind of interesting new concept. Matt suggested we become the suspension wagon.
Yeah, I mean, it only makes sense, right?
So first of all, a bunch of cards got suspended in Historic, which is the arena-only kind of like Pioneer-esque format. The last couple, it's double standard, last couple sets, plus standard. What does suspension mean? Suspension means these cards are now banned, or not, illegal to be played. But it means in March, when the season ends, the current season, these cards either become legal again or get banned for real. There we go.
Yeah, didn't take long.
So, effectively, suspension isn't different than banning, except it's just saying, this is like banning light, where in 3 months we're either going to get the cards back or they're just going to be banned.
Yeah, it's kind of like giving it a chance, like with one ranked season, to kind of see how things go.
Yeah, and that, you know, this is true of like almost any ban, where any ban can be reversed, right?
Yeah, a lot of modern bans have been right over the years. Not a lot, but...
But none within 3 months. Like, it's all been a matter of years. And even though effectively it's the same thing as getting banned, I do think... There is the key difference is, in a couple months, we're going to find out for real, but don't be surprised if it gets banned then, you know,
yeah,
that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Like, for reference, the four cards in Historic that were suspended were The Usual Suspects, Oko, Thief of Crowns, Veil of Summer, Field of the Dead, and Once Upon a Time. So, just a bunch of Magic cards that shouldn't have been printed, you know?
Yeah, so this list of cards is now all banned in Standard. All banned in Historic, and all but Oko are banned in Pioneer, is that right?
Yeah.
And Oko is not looking long for this world in Pioneer, though.
We'll maybe no, get to that no. I have found a couple formats where I like Oko existing, by the way.
Okay.
Vintage.
Okay.
Legacy.
Okay.
And then Cube.
Okay.
So far we're doing
good.
So it
should have been in, like, a Commander product or something.
Yeah.
That's the way to get it legal in just those formats.
Right. So... Yeah, I mean, we'll talk about Modern on another episode of the Suspension Wagon at some point. This bandwagon got some new suspension.
Yeah.
So, come here, Doug.
Oh, Julie's back.
Yeah.
Not every day you get a repeat appearance from Julie.
Yeah, she just got suspended.
So,
first of all, these cards, I mean, are all well-deserving of being removed from the format. I don't think really any of them are going to come back in March.
Yeah, I assume the idea of the suspension thing is more for future ones, where there are cards that maybe... Wizards is lower confidence in banning. These cards, I imagine, are all going to get the real axe, not just the half axe.
Yeah, don't half axe something. Yeah. So these cards, I mean, we've talked ad nauseum about why these cards really shouldn't be legal. They shouldn't be. Especially a format like Historic. Is it so much more powerful than Standard that they could accept something like Oko?
Yeah. I thought it was possible that some of these cards would be okay in Pioneer. I kind of now think none of them will, but Historic is too small. I guess one argument for the... Well, it's not really for the 3 month suspension thing, but for kind of looking at these cards maybe coming back long term, is this format's only going to grow, right? It is an eternal format.
It's true.
And so at some point, the format may be big enough that it can tolerate some of these more fair things if it pushes in a more unfair direction towards Modern or something like that. If you know, Kethi's combo and like other combo decks prove strong, although.
Well, it also could be the sort of thing where if an effective answer, say, to Field of the Dead gets printed in the next set,
right,
that means this maybe it's safe in a couple months to come back for Historic because, let's say there's, a card on the par with the power level of Field of Ruin, maybe a little bit better, which you could certainly make.
Yeah.
And then Field of the Dead's not as much of an issue.
Non-basic land hate isn't usually too much for Standard. Like, you don't necessarily want people stone raining each other on turn three or turn two, but... But you can have the type, but you don't need to answer Field of the Dead on turn two or turn three either. Right.
So I like the list of cards that got suspended here. Suspending them instead of banning them is kind of funny. It feels like suspending a habitual cheater over and over again before giving Alex Bertantini a lifetime ban. But yeah, like once upon a time in Oko aren't getting better.
No. Those are gonna move to the ban list. I would
But that being said, this move has a couple upsides. One is that they don't have to refund wild cards.
Yeah,
but I actually think that's okay because you can still play. Well, you can still play these cards in Standard, unless they got banned in Standard, in which case you got a wild card for them.
Right.
And it also means it gives Historic, you know, the creators of Historic a little bit more latitude in terms of putting these cards on the suspended list because the cost is lower.
Yeah, I'd rather them be willing to just pull the trigger on these things instead of being scared to because of that sort of thing.
Right.
Do you have any guesses for next cards on the suspension list? Like, Kethys combo stuff has to be a good guess, right?
Is probably number one just because it's not that fun of a deck to play against.
Right.
And, you know, getting Emry, I think, was like a pretty significant advantage to the deck, even though...
Yeah, it's got to be big.
Yeah, even though the deck, it's not... I don't think it's dominant in a way that indicates to me it has to be.
Yeah.
But part of it is we don't actually have data.
Right.
Because Historic hasn't had any of these, like, high-profile events that we've really would push people to try to maximize the format or break the format.
Yeah, one of the things the article mentioned is that kind of just the best of three ranked hasn't really caught on quite yet. So maybe once they push it with some events, we'll get a better sense of what the metagame actually looks like with people actually trying to break it.
And I found that like that part of the article like kind of not surprising.
Yeah.
Which was like, we haven't given competitive players any particular reason to pay attention to this format. And so competitive players haven't played it, which I think follows completely. So
it's just logic.
I'm not saying you have to bribe competitive players, but you have to make them feel like it matters.
Yeah, for sure. I mean,
So having a big tournament or having maybe higher entry fee, higher reward sort of thing.
Yeah, they've run those tournaments where like if you XO the tournament, you get like a big prize with higher entry.
Well, those tournaments are even free to enter.
Or even free to enter.
And yeah, that's the sort of thing that will get people to really try.
Yeah.
Just having the queue up, basically. There's plenty of people who will play, but I think people who want to hop in the queue and just play some games are more likely to want to play best of one than best of three.
For sure.
What about Nexus?
Yes, Nexus. The Peanut Gallery has said that Nexus is definitely a candidate.
Yeah. Those are the two kind of combo decks that are unfun to play against, right?
Nexus did get, you know, had action taken in standard. It wasn't banned fully, but in best of one.
Yeah.
Kethys, I think, barely escaped.
Just because it was rotating.
Basically, it came to fruition too late. Yeah. So it ended up in a spot where, had Kethys been as good, like, had the optimal Kethys list been out 2 weeks into the format instead of, like, 8 weeks into the format or whatever it was?
Yeah, it's interesting.
It might have been a little different. Because at the end, I remember watching and doing coverage of E-League, you know. At the end, it was just all Kethys.
Yeah.
But then it just rotated.
The mirrors are not the most fun to watch.
No,
any matchup involving the deck.
Kethys just doesn't do anything until it just casts 17 spells in the same turn.
Yeah.
Which hasn't historically been a play pattern people have enjoyed playing against.
But what about in Historic?
Yes. So I like where we're at. I think suspension is just a new tool in the arsenal, even if it's very close to banning. But it's like banning with an asterisk, where it's like, we'll make up our mind in like a couple months, you know?
Yeah.
Without the 3 month thing, it would make not that much sense to me, because then you're just banning a card and saying we might change our mind.
Right, which is just kind of the default assumption with bannings.
Right.
Yeah.
But I do like that you now have this option of, we're going to ban these cards, but in 3 months we're going to make a final verdict. We're going to see what the format looks like without them. I do find it funny that the first crop of cards getting suspended are cards that I just don't think should be legal in the format. No. So
they're going
to
be.
What is going to change your mind that make you think like, once upon a time, it's time to get this one back in?
Oh yeah, we need that one.
So, pretty cool stuff. And like I said, gives us some different aspect of things to talk about.
Yeah,
Definitely keep checking back in, because we're going to be covering some of the other formats and what else is going on. On the new suspension wagon. So, thanks for watching, and we'll be back next time.